You could have a what?
Grit.
There we go. You could have a what?
Grit.
There we go.
Too bad I went to graduate school to become a psychologist. I started to studying kids and adults in all kinds of super challenging setting. In every study, my question was, who is successful here and why? My research team and I went to West Point Military Academy. We tried to predict which cadet would stay in military training and which would drop out. We went to the National Spelling Bee and tried to predict which children would advance farthest in competition. We studied rookie teachers working in really tough neighborhoods, asking which teachers are still gonna be here in teaching by the end of this year, and of those, who will be the most effective at improving learning outcome for their students. So we partnered with private companies asking which of these salespeople is gonna keep their job and who's gonna earn the most money. In all those very different contexts, one characteristic emerged as a significant predictor of success. And it wasn't social intelligence. It wasn't good looks, physical health, and it wasn't IQ. It was grit. Grit is passion and perseverance for very long-term goals. Grit is having stamina. Grit is sticking with your future, day in and day out. Not just for the week, not just for the month, but for years. And working really, really hard to make that future reality. Grit is living life like it's a marathon, not sprint.
So I left the classroom and I went to graduate school to become a psychologist. I started studying kids and adults in all kinds of super challenging settings. And in every study, my question was, who is successful here and why? My research team and I went to West Point Military Academy. We tried to predict which cadets would stay in military training and which would drop out. We went to the National Spelling Bee and tried to predict which children would advance farthest in competition. We studied rookie teachers working in really tough neighborhoods, asking which teachers are still going to be here in teaching by the end of the school year. And of those, who will be the most effective at improving learning outcomes for their students? We partnered with private companies asking which of these salespeople is going to keep their jobs and who's going to earn the most money. In all those very different contexts, one characteristic emerged as a significant predictor of success. And it wasn't social intelligence, it wasn't good looks, physical health, and it wasn't IQ. It was grit. Grit is passion and perseverance for very long-term goals. Grit is having stamina. Grit is sticking with your future, day in, day out, not just for the week, not just for the month, but for years, and working really hard to make that future a reality. Grit is living life like it's a marathon, not a sprint.
So now I'm going to try to listen and repeat with Angela.
Life depends on much more than your ability to learn quickly and easily.
Okay, from here.
So I left the classroom. And I went to graduate school to become a psychologist.
I started studying kids and adults in all kinds of super challenging settings.
And in every study, my question was, who is successful here and why?
Who is successful here and why?
My research team and I went to West Point Military Academy.
My research team and I went to West Point Military Academy. Military Academy.
We tried to predict which cadets would stay in military training.
We tried to predict which cadets would stay in military training.
And which would drop out.
And which would drop out.
We went to the National Spelling Bee.
We went to the National Spelling Bee.
And tried to predict which children would advance farthest in competition.
And tried to predict which children would advance farthest in competition.
We studied rookie teachers.
We studied rookie teachers.
Working in really tough neighborhoods.
Working in really tough neighborhoods.
Asking which teachers are still going to be here in teaching by the end of the school year.
Asking which teachers are still going to be here, are still going to be here in teaching by the end of the school year.
And of those, who will be the most effective at improving learning outcomes for their students?
Who will be the most effective and improving learning outcomes for their students?
We partnered with private companies asking...
We partnered with private companies asking...
Which of these salespeople is going to keep their jobs?
Which of these salespeople is going to keep their job?
And who's going to earn the most money?
Who's going to earn the most money? Who's going to earn the most money? Who's going to earn the most money? Who's going to earn the most money? Who's gonna? All right.
In all those very different contexts. One characteristic emerged. As a significant predictor of success. And it wasn't social intelligence. It wasn't good looks. Physical health. And it wasn't IQ. It was grit. Grit is passion and perseverance. For very long-term goals. Grit is having stamina. Grit is sticking with your future. Day in, day out. Not just for the week.
Not
just for the month. But for years. And working really hard. To make that future a reality. Grit is living life like it's a...
Marathon.
Not a sprint.
Thank you, Angela. All right. Okay, so hello. Hi, how are you doing today?
Oh, I'm pretty good.
Are you still working at home?
Yes.
Okay, me too. So, well, today we are going to do from day 5 to day 8 all together. I found out that, you know, filming each day has been very challenging for me. So I'm gonna do like that, okay?
Okay.
So it's gonna be a little bit long, but please keep, you know, continuing watching, okay? All right, so can you please read this one for us?
All the way?
Uh-huh.
So I left the classroom and I went to graduate school to become a psychologist. I started studying kids and adults in all kinds of super challenging settings. And in every study, my question was, who is successful here and why?
All right. How about this one?
My research team and I went to West Point Military Academy. We tried to predict which cadets would stay in military training and which would drop out. We went to the National Spelling Bee and tried to predict which children would advance farthest in competition.
Very nice. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Probably this is going to be day 7.
Okay. We studied rookie teachers working in really tough neighborhoods, asking which teachers are still going to be here and teaching by the end of the school year, and of those, who will be the most effective at improving learning outcomes for their students. We partnered with private companies, asking which of these salespeople is going to keep their jobs and who's going to earn the most money.
Okay, can you come this way?
Oh, sorry.
All right, the last part.
In all those very different contexts, one characteristic emerged as a significant predictor of success, and it wasn't social intelligence. It wasn't good looks, physical health, and it wasn't IQ. It was grit. Grit is passion and perseverance for very long-term goals. Grit is having stamina. Grit is sticking with your future day in, day out, not just for the week, not just for the month, but for years, and working really hard to make that future a reality. Grit is living life like it's a marathon, not a sprint.
All right. Great job, great job, great job. So we're not going to listen and repeat this time.
Okay.
Okay, I already did with Angela, okay? So let me just ask some question. So what is graduate school?
Graduate school is what you go to after you have your bachelor's degree to receive or try to reach a master's degree.
Okay, so when you go to the 4 years university, mm-hmm. you're gonna get a bachelor's degree, but after that, if you want to get a master's degree, you're gonna go to graduate school. I see, I see. So, all right. Oh yeah, I got my master's from UTSA, right?
That was
my graduate school. All right. What about the West Point Military Academy?
That's the university school for, I think, individuals that are in the army.
Okay, I think that the school might be very hard to get in, right?
Yeah, I would.
Do you think so?
Yes.
Right, okay. All right, so how do you read this one?
Cadets.
Cadets.
Mm-hmm.
Cadets, say again.
Cadets.
Cadets. What does that mean?
That's what the that's what they call the people that are in that the military academy.
Okay. Can you please look at the camera?
Okay.
You don't have, there's nothing here. So the people who are trained.
Like they're enrolled.
Okay. Who are enrolled in this West Point Military Academy, they are trained, right? They are trained as a student, right?
Right.
Okay. What is a dropout?
Dropout is basically to leave your position where you're currently at.
Okay, so when you, let's say I am in the university, I am a university student, but I don't like to study, I can't study very well, so I don't want to go to school anymore, so what are you gonna say?
I'm gonna drop out.
I want to drop out,
right.
from school. Mm-hmm. I mean, I have never dropped out from school. Have you ever dropped out from school?
No.
Okay, so we're kind of lucky, huh?
Right.
Okay, good, good. All right, next one. National Spelling Bee. I know spellings, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you really have this kind of competition in the USA?
It's a national competition to
win. Oh, in the USA, right?
Right.
So all those kids or students, they come here, they try to you know, compete together.
Right.
Who gets the most, you know, spelling correctly.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, so they must be very smart.
Yeah, if they make it that far, they are.
Okay, I see, I see. All right, so in here, what does which children would advance, right? Advance. What is advance?
Advance is to basically move forward.
So this one is used as a verb in this sentence, right?
Right.
So I want to advance my English skills. Is that okay?
Yes.
All right, good, good. Okay, so we're gonna go to the next, you know, I think that this is gonna be day seven. I'm not sure how this MK teacher is going to, you know, cut it all the sentences, but I was just practicing, okay? So how do you read this one?
Rookie.
What is rookie?
Rookie is a term to basically dignify someone who's just maybe their first year at a position.
Okay, so you just got a job and then you are not experienced, right?
Right.
So maybe I just graduated from the university, I want to be a teacher, and this is my first year, right?
Mm.
Then I am a rookie teacher.
Right.
That means that I am not that really experienced, right?
Right.
Okay, am I a rookie teacher right now?
No.
I am not. But I remember that after I graduated from university, long time ago, I had a hard time as a rookie teacher because I didn't have really much experience. What is tough? Tough has a few different meanings, right?
Mm-hmm.
So let's say, hey, you're tough. What does it mean?
It can mean they're tough in their like physical stature.
Okay. Or mentally.
Mentally, yes.
You are mentally and physically very tough, right?
Right.
Are you tough?
Yes.
Am I tough?
Yes.
Am I tough?
Yes.
Okay.
Very, very tough.
Very, very tough. Okay. What about, English is tough, right? What does that mean?
English is tough to learn for non-native speakers.
That tough means difficult, right?
Right.
Okay, how about in this context? Working in really tough neighborhood, right? They're talking about tough neighborhood. What does that mean?
So they say it's a tough neighborhood. It most likely signifies that the economy of the area is well below what the city is at.
So their income can be very low, right?
Right.
Okay.
Maybe the crime rate may be higher.
Yeah. That means that kids are not really well. Kids are not having a good environment to study with, right?
Right.
I see. What about, okay, look at here, improving learning outcome. What is outcome?
Outcome is what's gonna achieve after the fact.
Okay, so it's a result.
Right.
Right, so what is today's learning outcome, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, after you watch this video, you will be able to understand whole sentences. Maybe you will be understand to speak. You will be able to speak and write
mm-hmm.
all these, you know, wonderful sentences from TED Talk, right?
Right.
Okay. How do you read this one?
Partnered.
Okay. So you are my partner, right? You are. How do you pronounce this one again?
They're using it in the past tense.
Right.
Partnered.
Partnered. Partnered.
Partnered.
Partnered, okay? But as a noun, you are my partner, right?
Yes.
But in here, this is the verb, so we partnered, okay? So what does that mean?
Basically, they work together.
Work together, right. Good. So they are working together with private companies, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. All right. What is emerge? So in this sentence, they said one characteristic emerge as a significant predictor of success, right?
Yeah.
So one characteristic emerge. What is emerge?
Emerge is something that basically became fairly highly visible.
Highly visible.
Right.
That you can see.
Mm-hmm.
Not actually see. You cannot see very well. It's invisible, but you can find out. Right? Something is immersed so that you can find it. Right?
Right.
Okay. What is significant?
Significant is, you can say it's very important.
Important. Okay. What is significant to you in your life?
You.
Okay. Can you make a full sentence, please?
Gina is very significant to me.
Okay, okay. Thank you. I did not ask him to answer that question, so I appreciate that. Okay, so what do you have? Okay, I'm not going to ask any other questions. So how do you pronounce this one?
Grit.
This is the title of this TED Talk, right? Grit. Say again?
Grit.
Grit. Alright, so they're gonna talk about all the, you know, the definition of the grit, right? So, how do you pronounce this one?
Perseverance.
Oh, I think that this is from the persevere, right? Persevere. Instead of verb, right?
Yeah, to persevere.
Okay, what does that perseverance mean?
Basically means to overcome something that's probably is very difficult.
Okay, so
just keep, you know, don't give up, basically.
Don't give up. Okay, guys, if you want to improve and speak English, or if you want to be fluent in speaking English, you gotta have to have grit, which is perseverance, right? Perseverance, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so grit is a passion, perseverance for the long-term goal. So, can I speak English like native speakers in 1 year? I don't think so, right? You need to really work hard, right? For the long-term goal. Maybe it can take like 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years. So, okay, what is stick with?
Stick with, basically keep going with what you're doing.
Right, so if you decided to study English, you need to stick with your plan, right? Okay, I'm gonna study for 1 hour every day, and then you need to stick with every day for a year. You have to stick with your plan. Then you're gonna achieve your goal, right?
Yes.
But many people, they don't stick with their plans. So what happened?
They don't achieve what they want to.
Exactly. So that's why they don't have a grit.
Right.
So, okay, you are smart, okay? You are beautiful, okay? You have a lot of money. Mm-hmm. It doesn't mean that you can speak English very well, right? You gotta have a what?
Grit.
There we go. You gotta have a what?
Grit.
There we go. You gotta have a what?
Grit.
There we go. All right, what about this one? Grit is living like, it's like a marathon, not a sprint. What are the difference between a marathon and sprint?
Well, a marathon is basically a unit of, it's a race, but a unit of measurement, which is, I think it's 26.2 miles.
Okay, maybe. It's a long marathon, right?
Right?
You have to run maybe 2 hours or four hours, right?
Yeah.
Maybe 10 hours, I don't know. That's a long marathon. What about the sprint?
That's a very short distance.
Right. So, the point is that grit is living like a marathon.
Mm-hmm.
So, oh my God, I want to really speak English like American by tomorrow. Nothing's gonna be happening like that way, right? You're gonna have to make a long-term plan to achieve your goals. Then, you have to have a passion, right?
Mm-hmm.
You have to have what?
Perseverance.
You have to have what?
Stamina.
And then you have to stick with your plan. Right, it's a marathon, right?
Right.
Okay, I think that I really like about the definition of the grit, right?
Mm-hmm.
So do you think that you have a grit?
Yes.
Okay. Do you think that you have a grit to learn Korean?
No.
Not really, right? Right. You need to really work on you know, right? Work on learning Korean. Right?
Hey, yes.
Okay. All right. Thank you for helping me out today. And we are going to see you next time. I'm going to say bye to...
Oh, later.
Hello, bye-bye. Have a good day.
여러분, 안녕하십니까? 자, 지금부터는 김미경 선생님과 영어 챌린지 5부터 8까지 한 방에 쫙 나가도록 하겠습니다. 자, 이번 주, 지난주에 제가 처음으로 그 챌린지를 데이별로 잘라서 하다 보니까 너무 좀 힘에 벅차? 한국말이 제가 조금 안 되네요. 미안합니다. 너무 좀 벅차서 한 번에, 그냥 한 방에 촥 올릴 테니까 여러분이 필요하실 때마다 오셔서 이렇게, 보시면 도움이 되시지 않을까 싶습니다. 여러분 어떻게 잘, 지난주 챌린지 잘 하셨습니까? 정말 너무나 많은 분들이 챌린지 참가하시는 거 보고, 정말 진짜 감동받았고요. 정말 많은 분들이 정말 영어에 대한 열망이 진짜 있는 것 같아요. 그리고 이제, 인스타를 통해서 제가 이렇게 좀 올리고 했더니, 우리, 한두 명 지금 댓글을 꾸준히 달아주시는 분이 있는데, 잠깐만요. 제가 한번, 뭐죠? 아이디, 응? 성함이 어떻게 되시는지 한번 아이디로 좀 볼게요. 왜 핸드폰이 잘 안 돼? 자, 이분들의 아이디가, 자, 박가혜님, 박가혜님 정말 감사합니다. 박가혜님, 이렇게 자꾸 응원의 메시지 남겨주셔서, 그리고 잘 보신다고 하시니까 제가 너무 기분이 좋고 힘이 많이 됩니다. 자, 그리고 우리 또, 이분 어디 가셨죠? 도전 모닝 듀님. 정말 감사합니다. 그 인스타에서도 해시태그 진화영어 달아주시고, 너무 많이 도움이 됐다고 해주시고 해서, 제가 힘이 좀 불끈불끈 나서, 오늘은 더 열심히 해보도록 하겠습니다. 계속 꾸준히 관심 가져주시기 바라고, 댓글, 여러분의 댓글은 저에게 정말 오아시스와 같은, 우리 모닝듀님께서, 모닝듀? 죄송합니다. 도전 모닝듀님께서, 제가 도전 모닝듀님의 그 오아시스와 같은 그 사람이었다고 하면, 여러분들의 댓글은 저에게 또 사막의 오아시스와 같습니다. 자, 거두절미하고, 자, 시작하겠습니다. I study to studying kids and adults in all kinds of super challenging setting. In every study, my question was, who is successful here and why? 자, 우리 주어 동사 찾아볼게요. I started, 그쵸? 그 다음에 I started studying kids and adults 하면 목적어가 되어 있습니다. In, 전치사. Plus all kinds of super challenging setting. 전치사 plus now는 전치사 구라고 말씀드렸죠. 그리고 in every study, my question was 여기가 이제 지금 접속사 end가 나왔고 in every question, my question was 주어 그 다음에 동사 나왔죠? 자, who is successful and why? Who 주어 동사 그렇죠? 자, 그러면 하나하나 조목조목 또 해석을 해드리도록 하겠습니다. I started studying. 나는 공부를 시작했습니다. 우리가 동사가, 자, 다른 색깔로 해볼게요. 동사가 이렇게 두 개가 올 때는 뒤에 있는 동사는 투부정사나 ing를 써주셔야 돼요. 그런데 start라는 동사는 사실 studying 하셔도 되고 아니면은 to study, 부정사 해도 됩니다. 근데 어떤 동사는 ing만 쓰고, 어떤 동사는 to만 쓰고, 또 어떤 동사는, 둘 다 쓰고, 근데 어떤 동사는 둘 다 쓰는데 의미가 달라요. 자, 그런 것을 제 영상 이렇게 제가 링크 달아드릴 테니까 한번 그 부정사, 동명사 찾아보시면 거기에서 좀 더 깊게 공부하실 수 있습니다. 자, 어쨌거나 여기 start 다음에는 you can say, I started studying. That's okay. Or, I started to study. That's okay. 나는 공부를 시작했어. 뭘 공부를 했냐? Kids and adults. Kids, 아이들과 adults 하면 성인이죠. 아이들과 성인들을 공부를 시작했다. 그쵸? 자, 여기 저번에도 말씀드린 것처럼 kids, adults 이렇게 S 오는 거. In all kinds, 모든 종류의 of super challenging setting. Super challenging setting이 이 all kinds로 꾸며주죠. 그래서 super, 영어에서는 정말 super이라는 말 많이 써요. very라는 말인데 I am super tired, I am very tired 해도 되는데 I am super tired, I am super hungry 이런 말 잘 씁니다. 자, super challenging setting. 그래서 아주 그 엄청난 그 도전이 되는 그 환경, 그쵸? setting 환경에서 환경에 있는 그 아이들과 성인들을 대상으로 해서 연구를 시작했다 그런 얘기죠. 그 다음 And in every study my question was Every는 항상 우리가 단수 취급해줘서 study, in every study에서 여기다가 아무것도 안 써요. Every는 항상 단수다. Every person, every student. 심지어는 뭐 student 할 때도 every를 쓰면은 이렇게 단수형으로 씁니다. So every study, my question was, 내 질문 중에 모든 study, 연구의 모든 질문 중 하나는 뭐였냐면, who is successful? 요거 발음 한번 같이 해보실까요? successful, successful, successful. 여기 accent가 오죠? successful. 누가 성공하는지. Who is successful here? 여기, 여기라는 것은 이 all kinds of super challenging setting이죠. 그죠? 모든 이렇게 엄청나게 어려운 환경에 있는 그런 setting에 있는 가운데에서도 누가 성공하는지, 그리고 why, 왜 성공하는지를 연구를 한 거죠. 그죠? 자, 우리 successful 이란 단어 조금 더 제가 설명드리겠습니다. 우리 succeed, succeed 동사. 그 다음에 success, success 하면은 명사, 그 다음에 successful 하면은 형용사 이렇게 됩니다. 자, 이렇게 단어의 품사를 제대로 아셔야지 문장을 구성할 때 조금 더 잘 되죠. So who is successful? 이럴 때는 successful 써고, 만약에 success 하면은 명사니까 명사에 맞게 써주셔야 돼요. 예를 들어서 the great is the key to success. 또 그 grit이 여기 제목이죠. grit이 성공의 key다. 이때 성공 to라는 그 전치사 뒤에 명사를 써주셔야 된다는 거죠. 그렇죠? 그리고 여러분이 예를 들어서 뭐 I 넘어가서 써야 되겠네요. I want to succeed. 나는 성공하고 싶다. 그러면은 I want 다음에 to 플러스 동사 원형. 여기서는 동사로 쓰였으니까 to 플러스 succeed를 쓰고 아까 그 전에 말했던 the grit is the key to success. 이때는 to success 하면은 자 전치사 뒤에는 명사가 온다. 이렇게 설명드리도록 하겠습니다. 자, 다음 넘어가서 My research team and I went to West Point Military Academy. 뭐 굉장히 아주 그냥 간단하게 나왔습니다. My research team and I 주어 그 다음에 went 동사죠. 주어와 동사. 여러분 주어일 때는 My research team and I라고 합니다. me라고 안 하고 주어 자리에는 주격을 쓴다. My research team and I. 그리고 went라는 것은 go의 과거형이고, 그쵸? 그래서 나의 그 연구팀이 갔다. 어딜 갔냐? 자, 어디로 할 때 전치사 preposition, 전치사 뒤에 West Point Military Academy. 그 West Point라는 군대 학교에 갔다. 자, 미국에서 이제 그 West Point Military Academy 가면 굉장히 그 실력이 좋은 학생들. 머리도 좋고 체력도 좋고 굉장히 또 훈련도 빡세서 여기에서 졸업한 학생들이 그렇게 쉽지가 않다고 합니다.
자, 그래서 이제 거기를 가서 조사를 한 거죠. 왜냐면 이렇게 어렵게 훈련을 받는 학생들 중에서 누가 살아남고 누가 떨어져 나가는지 그 이유는 뭔지. 그쵸? 오케이.
We tried to predict which cadets would stay in military training and which would drop.
자, 문장 주어 동사 또 한번 찾아보겠습니다.
We tried.
그쵸?
다음에 which candidate, which cadets, candidate잖아요.
여기 주어로 나왔네요. 그 다음에 would stay. 그쵸?
Would stay.
그리고
which.
그 다음에 would drop
out.
이렇게 보시면 되고요. 자, 동사의 과거형 썼습니다. tried 썼고, 그 다음에 여기는 조동사 would, 여기도 조동사 would, 조동사 뒤에는 반드시 동사 원형을 쓴다. would stay, would drop. 이런 식으로. 그쵸?
자, we try to predict. 우리는 predict 하면은 예견하려고 했다. 우리는 예측하려고 했다. 예측을 시도해 봤다. Which cadets? cadets란 단어는 그 우리말로는 뭐 생도, 사관 생도. 그쵸? 거기서 이제 훈련을 받는 학생들이니까 사관 생도죠. 어떤 사관 생도가 would stay 머물러 있는가? would stay 하면은 would는 이제 약간 여기에서는 이런 자기 의지를 나타내는 그런 의미를 담고 있는 조동사입니다. 자, would stay. 이 military training, 그 아주 혹독한 군대 훈련에서 누가 살아있고, 누가 살아남고, 그리고 would drop out. drop out 하면은 떨어져 나가다, 중퇴하다, 중도에서 탈락하다. 그런 표현입니다. 자, 그렇죠. 자, 그래서, 자, day 6로 가보겠습니다. day 6. We went to the National Spelling Bee and tried to predict which children would advance farthest in competition.
우리 단어부터 한번 같이 읽어볼까요? went. 같이 따라 읽어주시면 좋겠네요. went.
tried. predict. advance.
요 단어.
farthest.
competition. 여기 액센트가 competition. 이렇게 옵니다. 자, 단어 발음 먼저 한번 해봤고요. 다시 지우고 나서. 자, 우리 문장 구조 들어갑니다. 자, 문장 구조. 자, 우리는 주어, 갔다, 동사. 어디 갔다? To National Spelling Bee. 전치사 구. 그쵸? 그리고 접속사, 그리고 또 하나 동사가, 이 동사는 여기 앞에 있는 위와 연결되는 동사죠. 그리고 try to predict which children 주어 would advance 동사. 뭐 would는 조동사, advance는 본동사. 그쵸? Farthest in 전치사 competition 명사 전치사 구 그쵸? 아유 이렇게 그냥 시원시원하게 되네요. 여기서 우리가 단어를 좀 알아볼 게 뭐가 있을까?
자, we went 우리는 갔어. 어디 갔냐? To the National Spelling Bee.
전미 국가의 그 스펠링 비라는 거는 그 스펠링 그 컴퍼티션이에요. 경연 대회. 아주 거기 스펠링 컴퍼티션을 전국적으로 하는 거니까 거기에 가려면 굉장히 이제 우수한 학생들이 가겠죠. 그러니까 그 우수한 학생들 중에서도 왜 제가 우수한가 그걸 보고 싶었던 거예요. 그리고 try to predict. try to 여기도 동사가 지금 두 개. 동사 하나, 동사 두 개 왔으니까 to를 썼죠. try to. try 다음에 to 쓰면 I try to study hard. I try to exercise. 노력하다, S다. 그런 얘기예요. 자, I try to predict. 나는 우리는 예견을 하려고 했어. 우리는 예측하려고 했어. 자, 뭘 예측하려고 했냐? 자, 뭘 예측하려고 했습니까? Which children, 어떤 children, 아이들이 would advance. advance 하면은 여기서 동사로서 더 잘하는가, advance 하는가, 그죠? 더 잘하는가. farthest 하면 훨씬 더, farthest. 어느, 훨씬 더 잘하는가, 어디에서? in competition. in competition. spelling bee competition을 얘기하는 거죠. 이 spelling bee competition에서 잘하는가, 보는 겁니다. Okay, so day 7. 자, day 7. 자, 들어가겠습니다. We studied rookie teachers working in really tough neighborhood, asking which teachers are still going to be here in teaching by the end of the school year, and those who will be the most effective at improving learning outcomes for their students. 자, 여러분, 우리 발음부터 한번 볼까요? Rookie, rookie, rookie. 자, 따라 하고 계시죠? Tough, tough. 여기서 F, G-H가 tough, tough. Neighborhood, neighborhood. 그 다음에 여기서 원래 읽을 때는 are still going to. 그런데 요 미국식 발음은 are gonna be here. gonna. 우리말로 가나 초콜릿 아시죠? gonna. are still gonna be here. 그 다음에 얘를 한 방에 읽어주셔야 됩니다. by the end of the school year. 자, 그 다음에 effective. outcomes. 근데 가만히 보니까 이게 굉장히 저는 쉬운 단어라고 생각을 했는데 많은 분들이 이 단어를 발음을 좀 어려워하신 것 같아요. 발음이 student. 저 액센트를 정확하게 살려야 돼요. student. 자, 좀 물 좀 마시고 하겠습니다. 자, 그러면 발음 됐고요. 자, 혹시 발음 안 되고 하는 거 있으면 여러분 댓글에 달아주세요. 그러면 제가 도와드리도록 하겠습니다. 자, we studied. 우리는 공부했어. 누구를 공부했냐? Rookie teachers. 그렇죠? Rookie teachers 하면 rookie는 신입 선생님들. 그렇죠? Rookie라는 것은 그러니까 그 학교나 직장에서 처음 그 우리말로 뭐라 그러죠? 신입이요, 신입. 맞죠? 신입생, 신입 선생님. 경험이 없는 그런 선생님들이죠. 자, 경험이 없는 선생님들이니까 당연히 어렵죠. 그렇죠? 경험이 없으니까 너무 어려우면 그만둘 수도 있고. 그렇죠? 자, 그래서 경험 많은 선생님을 한 게 아니라 rookie teachers를 연구를 한 거죠. 자, working in a really tough neighborhood. 자, 전치사 플러스 명사 전치사 구 또 나왔습니다. 자, 그 다음에 또 하나 제가 짚어드리고 싶은 거는, 자, 여기 메인 동사가 studied예요. 그럴 때 또다시 work이란 동사가 왔죠? 그러면 여기서 ing를 썼죠. working하고. 어쨌거나 ing나 이렇게 또 동사 세 번째 거를 이제 썼었는데, ing를 쓸 때는 이렇게 능동의 의미일 때, 응? 우리나라에서 능동, 스스로 하는 거. 선생님들이 일하는 걸 스스로 하는 거니까 우리가 두 번째 오는 동사는 이렇게 처리를 해줘야 돼요. 자, 그래서 우리는 신입 선생님들을 연구했어. Working in a really tough neighborhood. Tough 하면은 굉장히 여러 가지 뜻이 있죠. You are tough. 너 진짜 터프하다. 너 진짜 터프한데. Tough guy 있잖아요. 뭐 육체적으로, 심리적으로 굉장히 강한 사람. 그 다음에 English is tough. English is tough. 영어는 너무 어려워. Difficult란 뜻도 있고. 근데 여기는 tough neighborhood 하면 이 동네가 굉장히 어려운 동네예요. 그러니까 뭐 예를 들어서 경제적으로 좀 economically 그리고 또 crime rate 범죄율도 좀 낮을 수도 있고. 저 앞전에 영상 보시면 저희 남편하고 제가 대화하면서 단어 설명을 영어를 또 영어로 했어요. 그런 것도 많이 들어보셔야 돼요. 여러분이 한글에만 너무 또 의존하시지 마시고, 아 나는 한글만 볼 거야 여기만 보고 싹 나가시면 안 됩니다. 시간 내셔서 꼭 가셔서 영어로 또 어떻게 말을 하는지, 그게 다 여러분 영어 학습에 일반적인 도움이 다 되는 겁니다. 그쵸? 자, 그래서 이렇게 어려운 그 아주 그냥 다 가고 싶지 않은 그런 동네, 그런 학군이 있잖아요. 그런 데에서 또 그것도 신입 선생님인 거죠. 그러니까 얼마나 어려워요? 자, 그래서 asking, 물어봤어요. asking, 자, which teachers, 어떤 선생님들이 are still gonna be here? be going to, be, are going to 하면은 future will 이라는 표현입니다. 그래서 여기에서 누가 있나, 여기에 누가 남아있나, 미래에, 그쵸? are still gonna be here. 왜? in teaching. 전치사, 구. 전치사 플러스 명사, in teaching. 뭐, teaching 하는데, 가르치는데, 언제까지? by 하면 까지라는 전치사, by the end of the school year. by the 라고 발음하세요. 자, 모음 앞에서는 항상 the 라고 발음한다. by the end of the school year. 학기 마지막, 그쵸? 학년 말까지 누가 가르치는데 누가 남아있는지 자, 본 거예요. 자, 그 다음에 and of those, of those 하면은 그들 중, 여기서 of는 중이라는 표현이죠. 그들 중, 그러니까 남아있는 선생님들 중 who will be, 동사 who, 누가 will be the most effective, 최상급이죠? the most effective. effective의 최상급은 the most effective, 가장 효과적으로 at 전치사 plus improving, 전치사 plus 동사가 오면 ing를 써줍니다. 전치사 plus 동사가 오면 ing를 써줍니다. improving, 향상시키는데 learning outcome, 우리 그 학습 목표죠. 학습 목표를 향상시키는데 가장 effective, 효과적으로 한 사람이 누군가, 그쵸? 누구를 위해서? for their students. 또 전치사구 나왔어요. 제가 계속 얘기하는데 영어는 전치사구, 전치사구 굉장히 뒤에 그 additional explain 하기 위해서, 부가 설명을 하기 위해서 전치사구가 계속해서 나옵니다. 자, 이해 가셨습니까? 오케이! 아유. 자, 그 다음에 이게 데이 7으로 제가 이제 추측을 했어요. 김미경 선생님이 어디서 끊을지 제가 모르니까 그냥 나름대로 추측을 했습니다. 만약에 데이가 안 맞으시면 앞뒤로 왔고 왔다 갔다 하시면서 같이 공부하세요. 오케이. Day 7, in my guess, we partnered with private companies asking which of these salespeople is going to keep their job. And who's going to earn the most money? 자, 발음부터 보겠습니다. Partnered, partnered, partnered. 우리말로는 파트너이죠. Partnered, partnered. Private, private, private. These, these. Salespeople, salespeople. 이게 발음이 people이 아니라 people. people, people. 약간 뿌뿌 발음이 나요. 뿌뿌. people, people. people 이러시면 안 됩니다. people, sales people. 아, 그 다음에 요거 발음 earn. e earn, earn. 알 발음 어렵죠. earn money, earn money. 자, 발음 해결됐습니다. 자, 문장 구조 들어가겠습니다. 자, we partner 주어 동사 with 전치사 plus 명사 asking ing 처리해줬고 which of these sales people 주어 결국 주어는 which예요. which. 자, 다시 정정하겠습니다. 얘는 설명해 주는 거 보조 설명. 그다음에 is gonna is going to 동사. 여기도 같이 제가 일단 해보겠습니다. Who 주어 is gonna 동사 earned the most money 목적어 이렇게 나오죠. 자, 그러면 해석 들어갑니다. 자, 우리는 partner 됐다. 우리 파트너가 명사로 쓸 때는 그 배우자 뭐 데이트 상대자 이렇게 되죠. 근데 partnered 하니까 이게 동사예요. 우리는 협력했다. 그렇죠? 같이 일했다. incorporated 됐다. 누구와? With, 함께, with private companies. 그, private, public이 아니라, 그 민간 기업들과, partner 해서, asking, 질문을 했습니다. 이, these salespeople, 자, these는 저번에도 말씀드린 것처럼, this의 복수니까, salesperson 하면 안 되고, person은 한 명이고, 복수형은 people입니다. 그래서 이 sales 또 어렵잖아요. 그 sales 하는 게 진짜 장난 아니죠. 이 sales 하는 사람들 중에서 누가 그들의 keep their job, 누가 그들의 일을 계속해서 하는가, 계속해서 keep 그만두지 않고 하는가, 이제 그것도 물어본 거죠. 그리고 who's gonna earn money. 여러분 earn money라는 표현 좋은 표현입니다. make money라고 하셔도 되고 earn money라고 하셔도 됩니다. 그래서 돈을 벌다. 그래서 누가 the most 최상급 the most who's gonna earn the most money? 누가 돈을 가장 많이 버는가? 자, 첫 번째는요. 웨스트 포인트 갔죠? 두 번째는요. 아주 어려운 학군 나쁜데 가서 선생님들, 신입 선생님들 조사해 봤죠. 마지막으로는 이런 민간 기업에서 세일즈 하는 사람들이 누가 가장 오래 일하고 돈을 많이 버는가 이렇게 본 겁니다. 자, 그래서 보면 day 8으로 제가 추정했습니다. Alright, in all those very different contexts, one characteristic emerged as a significant predictor of success. Those. 자, 발음해 보겠습니다. Those. context, characteristic, 그 발음, characteristic, characteristic, emerge, and then D가 거의 안 들리죠, emerged, significant, predictor, success. Alright. 자, 그러면 문장 분석 들어가 보겠습니다. 자, 전치사 plus all those very different contexts. 전치사 plus 명사, 전치사 구. One characteristic subject emerged. 동사. 그 다음에 as. 전치사, a significant predictor, 명사, 전치사구, 이것도 전치사구, 그죠? 그 다음에 of, 전치사, success, 명사. 그래서 이것도 전치사구. 자, 그러면 해석 들어갑니다. In all those very different contexts. Context라는 것은 그러한 다른 상황. 이 모든 다른 상황 가운데에서 모든 다른 상황 가운데서 one characteristics 한 가지의 특징 characteristic 특징이 emerged 나타났어 올라왔어 발견했다라는 결국은 뜻이죠. As 하면은 우리말로 여기서는 뭐뭐로서 a significant 아주 중요한 predictor 중요한 지표로서 of success 성공의 중요 지표로서 한 가지의 특징이 나타났다, 발견됐다. 그런 표현이죠. 오케이. 아유, 자. 자, 준비되셨습니까? 자, day 8. 여기가 이제 아주 하이라이트입니다. 요거 읽으면서 저도 감동을 많이 받았습니다. 그리고 동의도 많이 했고. And it wasn't social intelligence, it wasn't good look, it physical health, and it wasn't IQ, it was grit. Grit is a passion and perseverance for very long-term goals. Grit is having stamina. 자, 그러면 우리 단어 한번 들어가겠습니다. Social. Intelligence, looks, looks physical, physical. Great, great, great. Passion, passion. Perseverance, perseverance, perseverance. Long-term goals. Stamina, stamina. Okay. 자, 그러면 우리 문장 구조 파악 들어가 보겠습니다. 자, it, subject, wasn't, 동사, social intelligence, 주격 보어, 주어를 보충 설명해 준다. it, 주어, wasn't, 동사, good looks, 설명해 준다. 요거 설명해 준다. and it, 주어, 동사, 주어, 동사. 그쵸? great, 주어, 동사, 주격 보어, 주격 보어, for, 전치사, goal, 명사, 전치사 구, great, subject, 동사, is having, 동사입니다. 그리고 stem이라는 주격 보어, 주어를 설명해 준다. 자, 그러면 해석 들어갑니다, 여러분. 자, 잘 따라오세요. 자, it wasn't, was not, wasn't social intelligence. 그 성공의 비결은, 그 특징 하나는 사회적인 지능이 아니었다. It wasn't good looks. 좋은 외모도 아니었다. looks 하면, appearance. 외모란 얘기예요. looks. physical health, 신체적인 건강도 아니었다. it wasn't IQ, IQ도 아니었어. it was great, 끈기였다. 자, 아주 멋있는 말입니다. 그쵸? 자, great is passion, 끈기란 열정이야. perseverance, 인내심이야. for very long-term goal, 오랜 기간의 장기 계획을 위한 great is having 하면 현재 진행형 동사예요. 가지고 있다. great은 stamina, stamina를 갖는 것이다. stamina가 에너지인가요? 네. 아주 좋은 얘기입니다. 여러분, 성공하시려면 영어 공부도 마찬가지입니다. 오늘 내일 그냥 하루 만에 되는 게 아니라 이 모든, 지금 이 말 그 자체가 너무너무 와닿아요. 저도 지금 이 지경까지, 이 지경? 이 지경까지 오는데 이런 그릿이 없었으면 이렇게 할 수 있겠습니까, 여러분? 아주 오랫동안 고생 많이 했어요, 공부하느라고. 자, 여러분도 고생하셔야 돼요. 그냥 거저 얻는 건 없다. 고두절미하고 다시 또 들어갑니다. 자, 제가 한번 또 쭉 읽고 Great is sticking with your future day in, day out, not just for the week, not just for the month, but for years, and working really hard to make the future a reality. Great is living life like it's marathon, not a sprint. 정말 멋진다, 멋진, 너무 멋져. 막 감동의 눈물이 나올 것 같아요. 자, 여러분, 자, 발음 들어갑니다. Listen and repeat. 듣고 따라해 보겠습니다. Sticking with, sticking, sticking, sticking. Ears, ears. Reality, reality, reality. Reality 하면 안 되고, reality, reality. 아, 요거. Marathon, accent, marathon, 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 sprint, sprint. 자, 이제 저도 오늘 다 끝나갑니다. 저도 더 그릿이 필요합니다, 지금. 자, 문장 분석 들어가 보겠습니다. 좀 지우고. 자, Grit은 is sticking 동사 with your future. 전치사구. Day in, day out, not just for the week, not just for the month. 아, 여기에는 not but을 주목해서 봐주셔야 되고요. 그 다음에 working really hard. 얘는 working really hard은 여기에 sticking하고 working really hard 여기 같이 걸리는 거예요. Grit is sticking. Grit is working really hard. 그쵸? 왜요? To make the future a reality. 여기는 목적어. 그 다음에 Grit is living. 동사 life. Life is 목적어. Like가 여기에서는 전치사예요. 뭐뭐처럼. It's a marathon. 아, 이게 잘못된 것 같은데. It's. apostrophe가 없는 거예요. It's a marathon. It's 하면은 it의 소유격으로서 그것의 마라톤. 그러니까 인생의 마라톤. 이거 잘못 제가 했습니다. 자, so it's marathon. 그래서 전치사 플러스 명사. Not a sprint. 이렇게 됩니다. 자, 여러분 마지막으로 제가 그러면 해석을 쭉 한번 또 해보도록 하겠습니다. 자, 해석. 너무 복잡해. 아, 진짜. 자, 지우고 깨끗하게 하고 해석을 해드리도록 하겠습니다. 자, 그릿은 스티킹 하면은 딱 달라붙다. 떨어지지 않는 거야, 스틱. 우리 그, 여기 있다. 이거, 우리 영어로는 이거 스티키 노트라, 스티키. 스티키 노트. 그쵸? 스티키 노트. 왜냐면 스틱 하면 이렇게 스틱 딱 붙어서 안 떨어지는 거잖아요. 스틱. 아유, 여기다 구독 이렇게 써야 되려나? 구독. 어떤 분 보니까 여기다 구독하고 붙이는 분도 있더라고요. 자, 스티킹. 죄송합니다. 자, 여러분의 미래에 스티킹 무이 돼야 된다. 딱 달라붙어 있어야 된다. 그쵸? 그러니까 떨어지면 안 돼. 미래를 보고 그냥 꾸준히 달려가라. Day in. 그쵸? Day in, day out. 낮이고 밤이고, 그쵸? Not just for the week. 일주만을 위한 게 아니라 Not just for the month. 한 달만을 위한 게 아니라 But for a year. 하지만 한 달만이 아닌 그냥 몇 년간, 수년간을 위한 것이다. 맞습니다. Working really hard. 진짜 열심히 일해야 되고 왜? To make. 만들기 위해서. That future. 그 미래, 아까 우리 그 그릿이라는 것은 미래에 딱 달라붙는 거라고 했죠? 그 미래가 a reality, 현실로 바뀌기 위해서, 만들기 위해서 열심히 노력하는 것이다. 그렇죠? 그릿이란 living, 살아가는 것이다. life, 인생을 like it's marathon. 인생을 마라톤, 인생의 마라톤처럼 살아가는 것이다. Not a sprint. 단기 달리기가 아니다. Okay, 여러분. How was my explanation? 제 설명이 어땠습니까? I hope that, I know that this video is kind of long, but I hope that you can look through all this video for this week to study with. 이번 주 여러분 공부하시는데 많은 도움이 되셨으면 합니다. 자, I think that everybody is having a hard time these days due to coronavirus. 요즘 코로나 바이러스로 많이 힘드신 분들이 많은데요. 이럴 때일수록 please stay strong and stay safe. 그쵸? Okay. 여러분, thank you so much. And I hope that you have wonderful and beautiful day. And I hope you improve your English with me. Alright? I'll see you in the next video. Bye! 감사합니다.
So I left the classroom and I went to graduate school to become a psychologist. I started studying kids and adults in all kinds of super challenging settings. In every study, my question was, who is successful here and why? My research team and I went to West Point Military Academy. We tried to predict which cadet would stay in military training and which would drop out. We went to the National Spelling Bee and tried to predict which children would advance farthest in competition. We studied rookie teachers working in really top neighborhoods, asking which teachers are still going to be here in teaching by the end of this year, and of those, who will be the most effective at improving learning outcome for their students. So we partnered with private companies asking which of these salespeople is going to keep their job, and who's going to earn the most money. In all those very different contexts, one characteristic emerged as a significant predictor of success. And it wasn't social intelligence, it wasn't good looks, physical health, and it wasn't IQ. It was grit. Grit is passion and perseverance for very long-term goals. Grit is having stamina. Grit is sticking with your future, day in and day out. Not just for the week, not just for the month, but for years. And working really, really hard to make that future reality. Grit is living life like it's a marathon, not sprint.